turn it off.
Turn the lights on. Turn the lights on.
Where?
Right there. Blackout. Hit black. Hit the button so it's blackout. There we go. Up and right. All the way right.
Next week. Yeah. We'll talk later. Alright, guys. So, as the debate is kind of warming up, here's what's happening.
Hey, Dominic.
Listen! Listen.
Come back here.
So, this entire month, as you guys know, we're coming up to graduation for seniors. And so I kind of thought this would be a great month to focus on change and focus on how we deal with it, how we react to it, and just everything that goes along with change. So I challenged my band to play all secular songs the entire month. All secular songs. Not going to be a single Christian song in the whole list. Because that's what I wanted. For the past year, we've been playing music that you guys want. I was like, you guys want to play. So, man, I turn it over to you guys. Sit down for me. That is not how I wanted it to go. Oh, you guys are frustrating. My guys, you can have a seat for me. You can have a seat. So that was not the way it was supposed to go. So, what was supposed to happen? Listen. What was supposed to happen, and it happened on Monday, was they were supposed to get really, really mad and really frustrated with me. And they did. On Monday, they got really, really upset because they didn't know that I was kidding. I was playing along the whole time, and they attempted to play three secular songs that I gave them, and it didn't work out very well. But we are not having worship tonight just because of that message or that whole discussion with Pastor Steve, so our time is now backed up a little bit, so we're having to go straight into the message. So before we do that, get your hands ready. For those of you who are new, if you don't know who I am, I'm Alan, I'm the youth director. What we do is on the count of three, we clap together, all right? And this is the way that we can get our minds and our hearts ready to go into prayer. So get your hands ready. All right, 1, 2, 3. Good Father, I want to thank you for today, and I want to thank you for the opportunity that you gave Pastor Steve to come up here and share the vision that you have laid on his hearts and to give him the opportunity to answer the questions that these students have about change, about potential change, about things that are happening within the church as a whole church. Father, I ask that you be with me as I give this message and let me be your vessel and your tool to shape the hearts and minds of these students. In your name I pray. Amen. Okay. Change. Man. That's what we're focusing on. That's the entire month. Yes, we have to work. But the entire month's all about change. A lot of stuff is going to be happening to many of you over the next couple of weeks. If you're in eighth grade, you're moving on to high school next year. You're moving on to being freshmen. If you're a senior, you're moving on to college. Or you're moving on to the military. You're moving on to the workforce. You're just moving on. You're becoming adults. But even for those who aren't making drastic changes like that, we're still making changes. Many of you guys are starting to do driver's ed this summer. That's a huge change. That's a big change. Many of you are going through just changes yourself. Maybe you're moving, or maybe you are changing location. Maybe you're changing schools. Whatever the case may be, but something is happening. And so for the next 3 weeks, there's only going to be 3 weeks. The fourth week we're going to do, we've got announcements. I need to, guys, don't forget to remind me to do announcements after the message. Please don't forget me. Don't let me forget. Anyway. Yes, don't forget me.
Jalen, put it away.
We're going to look at what scripture talks about change and how you deal with change. What's the best way to handle it? Because change is scary. Change is really scary. It's very uncomfortable. Many of us don't like it. I am one of those. I hate change. But ironically, I chose a career, or I was called into a career, that causes me to change all the time. So, let's see what scripture says. So we're reading out of Ecclesiastes, which is in the Old Testament, chapter 3, verses 1 through 8. And this is what God says. There is a time for everything, and a season for every activity under heaven. A time to be born and a time to die. A time to plant and a time to uproot. A time to kill and a time to heal. A time to tear down and a time to build. A time to weep and a time to laugh. A time to mourn and a time to dance. A time to scatter stones and a time to gather them. A time to embrace and a time to refrain. A time to search and a time to give up. A time to keep and a time to throw away. A time to tear and a time to mend. A time to be silent and a time to speak. A time to love and a time to hate. A time for war and a time for peace. Yep, there's a lot of times. So, change. What is change? Change is simply a modification of your routine, of your habits. That's all really change is. So you're an eighth grader, you're going to high school next year. Your routines are going to change because your school changes, your environment changes. So you have to deal with that modification. If you're starting to take driver's ed, your life is going to change. It's going to change because now you have to pay for insurance, you have to pay for a car, you have to pay for gas, you have to pay for driver's ed, you have to take driver's ed. So how do you manage that? How do you handle that? Gentlemen, enough. How do you handle that? How do you handle, let's take Davis for example, how do you handle mid-year moving to a new high school where you don't know anybody? We have one young lady in here, she's not here now, but one young lady who's going to be leaving at the end of this month to move to North Dallas, or I think North Dallas. Anyway, regardless, but she's moving to a new school. The modification of your routines and habits. And that's scary because we get so accustomed and so used to what we do every single day that it's hard to make or to accept that change. We get frustrated, we get annoyed, short-tempered, aggravated, we don't sleep, we don't eat. We stop doing things that we enjoy doing because we're so fixated on that modification. Because sometimes we know that modification is coming. We know that change is coming. And so it makes us nervous. That butterflies in your stomach, that nauseated feeling that you get. But you see, God is always there with you. And as you see, there's a time for everything. So the key to change is embracing that change. It's to understand that nothing is bad is going to happen to you. So for example, the skit that I was trying to get the band to do today was to demonstrate that. They had a change, a modification to what they're accustomed to. For all year long, all they've been playing is Christian music. And all of a sudden, I threw a wrench to the plan and said, I want you playing secular music. And now they have to address that change. And I can tell you, if you were here on Monday, it would have been a different picture. They were steaming with anger about this change that I was trying to force them to do. All because their routine was different. Now, the routine really wasn't that different, and the whole point of the whole skit was to show that nothing bad happened because of the change. You see, that's what we're so afraid of. We're afraid of the unknown. We're afraid that something's going to happen to us because we can't predict it. The band was frustrated because they were afraid of judgment. They were afraid to perform poorly. And the songs were not going to sound right, and you guys were not going to be involved, and it was not going to go very well, and it would make them look bad. But the idea of worship is all about connecting yourself with God. It doesn't matter if it's secular music. It doesn't matter if it's only instrumental, no one's saying anything. It doesn't matter. Worship is just meant to connect you with God. So the idea that judgment or insults would be hurled at them, that you guys would have stones ready to stone them because they perform poorly, is an irrational fear. But it's a fear that every single one of you guys experience. Now I can tell you from experience that I don't like change. I am a creature of habit. The youth pastors in town, myself, First Baptist, First Assembly, and a couple others, we've been meeting every Monday for the past year over at Bull Shack. I walk in and Miss Julie knows exactly what I want. She already has it made before I'm even there. Because I'm a creature of habit. I do the same thing over and over and over again. Because it makes me comfortable. It makes me safe. The same thing it involves with you guys. And sometimes this fear of the unknown is so powerful, it actually prevents you from experiencing the world. It may prevent you from reaching out and actually trying something. You know, you may want to try a new sport that you've never played before, but you've always liked. But you're afraid to go try it because you're afraid of failure. You're afraid of looking bad. You're afraid of people making fun of you. But here's the ironic part. Why are we afraid of that when we don't know how to do that? So what I want you to hear me saying is that you shouldn't be afraid of change. Because as we just read, there's a time for everything, and God knows that time. Every season that you're in, He has specifically planned for you. He's not, I want Chase to do this then. Oh, he has to do that. It's not blindly picking your life. It's not blindly guiding you into a new direction. He knows exactly what's happening. When Christ lived and He walked amongst us, He knew what was coming. He had known for a long time that He was going to that cross. After the supper, when He was in the garden, and as He was praying to God, God was revealing to Him everything that was about to happen over the next 3 days. And you even see Christ, our Savior, our Lord, in fear of change. He starts to sweat blood. He even begs God, if it be your will, take this cup from me. Because he didn't want it. He wanted to continue to minister. He wanted to continue to be with his friends and continue to do good in the world. He didn't want change. He didn't like change. Nobody likes change. But he embraced it. He's like, fine. If I must go to the cross, then I will go to the cross gladly. I will rejoice in the suffering. I will rejoice in giving up myself for you. You know, I always mention this little quote that my mentor taught me. I think it applies here very well, but you may walk 1,000 miles from God, but God's always one step behind you. And so as you start to change, as you start to go through these changes, know that you're not there alone. Know that you're not experiencing this change by yourself. First off, you have all of your classmates with you. So all the seniors who are graduating, you're not graduating by yourself and no one else is graduating. You have a whole class full of people graduating with you. For those of you who are in 8th grade, you're going to be freshmen. There's a whole bunch of 8th graders who are going with you. You're not by yourself. For For those of you who are trying a new sport or trying a new instrument or just trying something new, there's a whole bunch of people who are trying something new with you. And so I want you to look at your life, and I want you to look at the summer, I want you to look at this next couple of weeks, and look at the change that's going to happen to you. And try to figure out for yourself, how are you going to handle this? How are you going to manage your change? Are you going to become reclusive, isolated, depressed because you are afraid of that change? Or are you going to stand up and embrace and say, you know what? I'm going to start now creating new routines so that when I do experience this change, those routines are already set in place. Here's a great example. Typically, employers pay you at the beginning of the month and the middle of the month, typically. This church doesn't do that. This church pays you on the 10th and the 25th. And so for me, that makes things kind of awkward because rent's due the first of the month. But yet I don't get paid until 10th. And so I'm so accustomed to having my money before rent is due in order to be able to pay my rent. And so when I moved here, I had to change everything to satisfy that new modification in my routine. And at first it was a struggle. I was spending a lot more than I was bringing in, and I was not keeping up with my credit card very well because I was having to readjust the way that I was managing my money because of this new change. But I, instead of being afraid and frustrated and aggravated, I just embraced it. I said, okay, whatever, it happens. And now I'm on track. So how are you going to deal with change? How is your faith going to help you deal with your change? How are you going to embrace what God has put before you? Because God doesn't put anything before you that you cannot handle. Trust me, there is no one else on the planet who knows you better than He does. He knows your strengths, He knows your weaknesses. And one last thing I want to share with you guys about change is change helps you grow. Let's say you become a freshman in high school, but that's all you do for the rest of your life. You stay as a freshman in high school forever. How do you get better at something? How do you grow smarter if you don't move to 10th grade? If you don't move to 11th grade? If you don't move to 12th grade? If you don't move on to college or move on to the military or a trade school or whatever? How do you grow? You stay the same exact way all the time. How can you become better? That you can't. What if I preached the same exact message every single Wednesday night? We have a rather large group tonight. Do you think that we'd have this large group if I preached the same exact message every single Wednesday night?
No.
No. Yeah, it'd be boring. It'd be very boring. Be very boring. Embrace change. Don't be afraid of it. Don't let your fear overtake you from stopping you from doing something that you want to do. My last story is when I was in college, I went to community college first, then I transferred to university. And when I transferred from community college to university, I had decided that I was going to fully embrace my change. I really wanted to be involved. I really wanted to be active. I wanted to make a name for myself on campus. And so every opportunity that I got for a leadership role, I did whatever I could to take that leadership role. And I got most of them. But very quickly, I generated a very positive reputation for embracing change and for going after things that I desire, because I was not going to let it stop me because I was afraid. Because I was afraid that people weren't going to vote for me for being class president, or people weren't going to vote for me to receive an award, or whatever the case may be. I didn't care if I stood up in front of everybody and made a fool of myself. I was going to go and put myself out there and take a risk. Was it scary? Very much so. Did I have a blast doing it? Oh yeah. Some of the greatest memories I have from college is when I decided to embrace change. To try to face it head on. To know that things come in seasons, as we just heard. There's a time for you to cry. There's a time for you to rejoice. There's a time for you to dance. There's a time for you to do this. There's a time for you to do that. And right now, we're in that month where a lot of things are ending. But at the same time, a lot of things are starting. We pray with you. Dear Heavenly Father, I want to pray a special blessing over each of these students. I ask that you come and be with them right now, in this very moment. Give them the strength to embrace change. Give them the courage to step out, to modify their routines so that when their routines get modified, they're not afraid. Father, I ask that you be with each of us as we go into the world. Give us the strength to show the world that change is not scary. As a body of believers, we can support one another through these difficult times of change. That we can uplift and encourage and love one another. Provide them words and support that give them the strength to continue to move forward. Father, as we leave here tonight, I ask that you just be with us and give us safe travels home. In your name I pray. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you. Announcements, my friends. Announcements. Can you go to the announcements, please?
Announcements.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Okay. 4 weeks. 3 weeks. 4 weeks. 3 weeks. Something like that. 3-4 weeks. BBS. We still need a few more of you guys to sign up to help out being station leaders or crew leaders or whatever. It's in the back. The sign up is in the back on the table. So go back there and sign up. So VBS, listen, shh. VBS is the first week of June. And it's Vacation Bible School. It's where all the little kids basically come for a week and learn about God, learn about Jesus, and they have a lot of fun, big blast. But they need you guys as role models to kind of help them through that week. So, please go sign up for it. The next one, please. Next. As Pastor Steve said, if you have never been baptized before and you want to get baptized next Wednesday, please come talk to me tonight and let me know so that I can tell him and we can have a rough count of how many are going to be baptized next Wednesday. And as I said, there's a tank in this closet. And we'll pull it out and fill it full of water and, you know,
warm water.
And we'll.
That's cool.
Anyway, so please let me know. Please come talk to me about it. Next.
Please remember a towel and extra clothes.
Yes, towel and extra clothes, please. Towel and extra clothes. Our kickoff to summer party is going to be Wednesday the 25th. You guys will have already been out of school for about a week by then. Some of you will be in flex, but my idea right now, this is my idea, and I've already bought the supplies for the party at night, but my idea is that we would go to Camp Choye for the day, and then come back, oh, there you are, actually, I didn't talk to you, and then come back here and have a neon blacklight party in here, with a whole bunch of neon paint and a lot of bumping music, and I think it's going to be awesome. Yes? No. So, real quick, I need to address this. Real quick. Gentlemen, I'm not going to ask you again. Over there. Thank you. So, both junior high and senior high have asked me for lock-ins. Listen, first off, lock-ins are very difficult. They're difficult because I have to find adults to come in to give up their time and to stay up all night long with you guys, and that's very hard. All right, this is the reason why we don't do them very often. because it is very hard and very difficult on the adults. Mm-hmm. You guys don't know this, but I'm the only one who gets paid to do this. They're doing this on their volunteer time, and so they have to go to work and stay up all night long. They don't get the privilege to go home and sleep the next week like you guys do. So it's very, very hard, but I am trying desperately to plan two more lock-ins for this summer, one for junior high and one for senior high. All right. So I just want to address that right now. We will have some more, but stop asking, please, because it takes time and it's hard for me to put together. Okay, moving on. No, it is not. It does not cost. It's free. The whole day will be free. Next one. Next stop. Seniors, for the few seniors that I have in here. Senior Sunday will be the 25th, not the 25th, 29th. Sunday the 29th. In 3 weeks, the 18th, the very last week that we'll have regular youth group, seniors, we will be meeting from 7:30 to 8. We're going to be talking about how Senior Sunday is going to look, and what's going on, and what the whole event is going to be about. So please be here, be for that. Ashley, Lacey, Sam, you guys, tell those who are not here, Garrett and Robbie as well, tell those who don't regularly attend, who do want to participate, that they need to be at this meeting Wednesday the 18th, 7:30 to 8, okay? So that we can get all the seniors on the same page about that. Underclassmen, including junior high, you guys will be serving breakfast to the graduates between services, all right? So at about 9:30-ish, you guys will be serving breakfast to them. Now you all will be able to eat, but they get to eat first. Them and their immediate family get to eat first. I don't know what we're gonna serve you yet. I think we're gonna do pancakes. Maybe like chocolate chip pancakes and bacon and
pancakes.
So I don't know. We'll see. All right. We're almost done. Next one, please.
Boom.
Okay. I already talked about that one. Next one. Okay. So, very last thing. I don't have it on here. You may see this little button. Some of you have asked me about this. This summer, most of the youth groups in town are coming together and we're putting on a mini conference. It's called 412. It's based off of 1 Timothy 4:12. And there's three Wednesdays throughout the summer that we're going to be at different churches. In August, we will be here. But in June, we'll be at First Baptist, and in July, we'll be at First Assembly. And man, I need to talk to you guys. We're performing in June, just FYI. But anyway, what's going to happen is we're going to go to different churches, and this is a total ecumenical, which means a total Christian-based conference, all right? All the denominations are coming together, and it's not going to be a single denomination. It's going to be one big Christian church. We're going to have games, food, worship, celebration. It's going to be awesome. It's going to be a lot of fun. We're going to have these to give out, these little pins, and we're also going to have t-shirts that we will be selling for that. We'll sell t-shirts. Yes, Nana?
They're meeting at the prospective churches, correctly?
No. At least not right now. My plan right now is we meet here and we bus over there. Just because it's hard for some of you guys to get to and from, or you don't know where it's at, or whatever the case may be, it's easier for you guys to come somewhere you know, and then we'll bus over there and do all that sort of stuff. So, but that will be, I will make that determination later on this week once I get with our church secretary to see what vehicles are available, if we even have any vehicles available that night. What else? Do you have any other last announcements, something to think of? Last announcements. Lakeview, we still, oh, that's a good point. Big House, Junior High, listen. Junior High, listen, this is for you. Big House has been canceled. Nobody signed up. So, we're doing an internal Big House. Same exact dates, but we'll do it here on campus. It'll be much, much cheaper than what the travel Big House was going to be. But I will have signups and information for you guys next week. And I just wanted to let you guys know about that. Lakeview. We're still taking sign-ups from Lakeview, but remember the prices are going up now because we're getting closer to Lakeview. It's the week after VBS, so that's the 13th of June. Applications are in the back on the table. Please fill them out and turn them in to me, and then come talk to me about payments and all that sort of stuff. And yeah, yes. June, I don't know, I can't remember. I can't remember off the top of my head. Yes? No. 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 It's like the end of June. I can't remember the exact date. Alright. What are we doing now? What are we doing? Oh, senior high, go to your classrooms, please. Junior high, you staying here. We're going to the small groups.
Oh, your backpacks and everything, because you're going down. Are they getting their backpacks out there?